Patients who are planning cataract surgery or refractive lens exchange, in my experience, usually doing three major mistakes which can dramatically affect your quality of vision and quality of life after the surgery. In this short video, let me explain about these three type of mistakes and let me help you to understand what you should focus on before the surgery to be happy after the surgery. Hi there, my name is Alexey, you are at IOL-adviser.com channel. Majority of patients are not aware that they are able to choose the intraocular lens the doctor will place inside of your eye. In many cases, if you don't have any medical restrictions, which is the case for majority of patients, you are able to select different type of IOLs from monofocal to extended range of vision or full range of vision lenses called multifocal or whatever, you have a flexibility to choose and to discuss it with your surgeon. Of course, in many countries, monofocal lenses are paid by the government, reimbursed, etc. And it's good that we have that options. But in many cases, patients are not thinking further because they underestimate the problems which standard monofocal lenses will bring to their life. What the problem are? It is shallow depth of field with standard monofocal lens. What is depth of field and how does our eye work? What is depth of field and why it is so important? When we are young, we can see clearly in the far, intermediate and near distance without use of glasses, or even with use of glasses, we put the glasses on and we see clearly at all the distances. Why it is happening? Because we do have a so-called accommodation mechanism. Because our natural lens can adapt to different distance from our eyes to focus sharply on the retina to give you a sharp vision at any distance desired. At the age of 40 plus, with some people earlier, with some people a bit later, but it happens to everybody, that accommodation starts to degrade. And with age, we cannot see clearly at the very close to the eyes. We shall move our, let's say, reading object or our phone a bit further from our eyes to see it clearly. And at the end of the day, we have to use reading glasses, so-called readers or whatever, magnifying glasses to see up close very well. But when we use the glasses, we don't see far well. We have to remove it again and to see far objects in a clearly and sharp manner. And the degradation of the accommodation, it's a slow process, and the accommodation range decreases slowly. And what is important to know that even at age of 70, when you still have small amount of residual accommodation and you cannot see well, the range of accommodation in your later ages is still wider than you got with a standard monofocal lens. In other words, if you use your glasses for reading in, let's say, your later age, and then you think that you will put the monofocal lens and you will have the similar visual experience, or let's say the same visual experience, in majority of cases you are wrong. Of course, you will be able to see up close very well with readers, and you still will be able to see far without glasses. But the problem is your visual experience without readers will be way worse in majority of cases with monofocal than you had before the cataract with your age of 60, 65, at even 70. So in majority of cases, the downside of monofocal lenses are very much underestimated. So as you can see, the first mistake of a patient undergoing cataract surgery is that they are not thinking about other options they have. They're not thinking about different IOL types. And the second big mistake, that patients in many cases underestimate their visual needs and needs in high quality vision and different distances. Why is this happening? Especially in cataract, especially in cases of cataract surgery. When a patient's vision starts to degrade, and the cataract is a slow process normally, and the vision is degrade slowly, and patients used to have this low quality vision, and one day you realize that your vision is so cloudy, so blurry, so hazy, you are willing to remove this hazy media out of your eyes and you want to see clearly. And if you're already tired of the bad vision, you are waiting for a few months before your surgery and you're already tired, you're bored by this, your first intention is to remove it as soon as possible to get high quality vision, to see clearly again. And it gives you kind of understanding or behavioral bias. You are not thinking further about your visual needs, about your experience in your daily life after the surgery. And I have a lot of patients coming back to me and saying, well, I'm so unhappy with monofocal lens. I'm so, sorry that I didn't talk to my surgeon before I didn't saw your videos before, and now I have to struggle and I have to work, I have to live with my monofocal lens. How to avoid this mistake? I encourage you to think about your daily life activities. Whatever you are doing, try to freeze and think, what I'm doing now? Am I using glasses now? Am I okay with this? Or I'd like to be glasses free at that particular, let's say, occasion, that particular activity. Is glasses absolutely good for you, or you absolutely don't want to use the glasses? So it's a lot of reflection needed. And normally, if you take about few days, maximum 1 week, about self-reflection, maybe write something down, think, maybe ask your family members to help you with that. Just think and reflect how you want to see, what you want to see, for what activity you need glasses today, and probably what would you like to see clearly without glasses in the future after the cataract surgery. And now we're coming to the third and major and most important mistake and the most challenging part in your way to the cataract surgery and to the, let's say, better life, a better vision after the cataract. And this part is doctor's communication. It doesn't matter, is it a direct communication to your surgeon or to counselor or to optician, doesn't matter. The biggest mistake a lot of patients doing here is that you are trying to focus on surgical safety, maybe cost, would it be painful, how long you will be recovering, etc., etc. But honestly, it is the least important questions, it is the least important discussion. And the most important discussion is how you will see without or with the glasses after the surgery. And what does it mean, how I will see? It relates to two important topics. The first one is the measurable side of this equation, I would say. It's a visual acuity at different distances from your eye. And what is important is the contrast sensitivity and quality of vision in dim light conditions or at night conditions. The first one is a far vision. It's 2 meters and further. Second is intermediate vision, which relates to about 60 to 80 centimeters from your eye. And the third range is near vision, roughly 35 to 40 or 40 to 50 centimeters from your eye, somewhere here. So in ideal world, you have to know your visual acuity at near, intermediate and far vision, because all the three distances are very important. And normal practice, we measure only far distance. And in many cases, doctors and patients are not aware and not thinking, not talking about near and intermediate vision in terms of visual acuity, and not talking about reading or working ability and this range. The most important is to discuss with your surgeon, either in numbers, if you have it, but if not, I encourage you to talk with the surgeon in a simple words like, doctor, I would like to read without glasses. What exactly and how long? And if you're talking about computers, it's important for you to talk with the doctor. Is it a notebook with a smaller screen and shorter distance, or it's a large screen computer with a bigger distance, bigger screen, because it's different distances and different lenses perform differently. It will give you a full overview of the options available, and you will be able to select the most optimal IOL for your particular visual needs. And in this case, most probably you will get the highest vision quality and the optimal and the maximum quality of life with the newly restored vision after the cataract surgery. Discuss with your doctor quality of vision before the surgery, now, and what you shall expect after the surgery. Plus, talk about this visual experience expectations, normal lighting conditions, and in dim light conditions. What changes I might expect after the surgery with a particular IOL, which you selected for my particular case. Would it be better than today, or what is important, if you remember your visual experience, and I believe you do, try to discuss with your surgeon rather not in visual acuity numbers, but in your visual experience. Doctor, let's say 5 years before my disease or before the surgery, I was able to do reading, writing, whatever, here or here. After my surgery, with the lens you offer me, would I see better, same way, or worse at near, intermediate and far? And then finally you will be able to take the best decision together with your surgeon. And in this case, I believe that your eye surgery results will be maximally personalized for your particular visual needs.